Coastline, a place where we like to call mini Las Vegas, where opportunity is really what you make it. I mean, we got the beautiful beaches, the long coastal line. A lot of people really don't believe it's Mississippi when they see it. Sometimes I ask myself, is this how it was planned? Is this really how it was written?
All about, man. You know what I'm saying? So my nigga trap many nights. You know what I'm saying? Play ball, all that old shit. Get to this point. I always knew we'd get here. You know what I'm saying? So you know, the putting in the work to get to this point, I ain't never had a problem with that.
You see, blood makes you related, but loyalty makes you fam. I think every man has a sense of pride, but you can't let that pride get in the way of getting your money. Sometimes the fear of not being able to compete brings hate and envy, not knowing that you're your only worst enemy. I like to think about it sometimes like God put me here for a special reason, because ever since I've been here, I've been blessed to be a star. So with that being said, it's only right that I share my blessing.
You know, it look like shit is just beginning to be an epidemic. Like, niggas is just thinking that's the route to go. Niggas ain't got no respect for the game. You know what I'm saying? They don't got no respect for the OGs. Like, niggas that paid away. All the young niggas feel like they are them niggas before they even put in some work to get there. You know what I'm saying? Like I said in my rhyme, I said niggas playing with ounces, acting like they bricks. The middleman of a middleman shit. You know what I'm saying?
Is this how it was planned? Is this really how it was written? I know without a doubt I've been blessed to make it this far. Based on the things in my life I done been through. I like to think about it sometimes like living more than one life, because we done seen life from so many different angles.
You use my house for a gathering post, and your loyalty to your friends is you would get put out for your friends. Since you were 8 years old, I knew you wanted to be a rapper. When you were a child, I think you probably was around 9 in the fourth grade, you wrote this rap for Bell South. And you won a statewide competition for relief. And Bell South was doing a campaign to go green by planting trees and flowers and gardening. I'm glad to see you being successful and realizing your dream, because it's been a lifelong dream of yours to rap and sell your records. I mean, even from the time when you were underground, before college, after college, in the trunk of the car, everywhere selling your CDs. And so it's good to see you coming on up and doing big things and doing what you love to do, which is rapping.
I came from nothing with it, really came from nothing with it. I came from nothing with it, really came from nothing with it. I know they mad just to see me out just stunned with it. I know they mad just to see me out just stunned with it. I came from nothing with it, really came from nothing with it. I came from nothing with it, really came from nothing.
Well, you know, with me and my music, man, it's mainly just me just doing me, you know, staying focused on what's real to me, and trying to get my fans and the people that fuck with me the real me. You feel me? It's like, you know, I really don't want to be out here selling nobody no dream. You know what I'm saying? Cause it's sleep when I die with me. You feel me? So, I mean, you know, my career has always been based around the real. I dealt with a lot of different cats, you know what I'm saying? Cats that I felt like was real, cats that I had love for, cats that I thought had love for me, but at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying, you really see who real and who fake, you know what I mean? like a lot of people was put here for different things, man. And you know, in my situation, I've been a boss all my life, so I mean, it's like it's obvious that's what I was put here to do, lead, you know. And I think I've been doing a great job doing that, but you know, a lot of people get the game twisted, you know what I'm saying, and they are listening to different people and shit like that. But you know, real niggas do real things, you know. When it's with your partners and your fam, it's deeper than rap, it's deeper than any of that shit. If a nigga really give a fuck about you, none of that shit matters, because the competition level in any business is always gonna be high. Like the nigga sitting on you sitting on a mill, your partner them can be sitting on a few hundred thousand. They want a mill too, you know, but the real nigga's gonna figure out how to get the mill. He's not gonna stab his leader, stab his boss in the back trying to get the meal. He gonna take whatever he get from that situation they got going on together, create his own, put it all together, and get his meal too. You know, I got this new project I've been working on for a long time, and I done dealt with a lot of different producers on this. I'm talking about from the dirty south all the way to California, Oakland. You know, I done dealt with a bunch of different motherfuckers, and I'm knowing like this some of my best work, you know, as I put it down, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to my little homie B-Real, you know what I'm saying? He came through and hooked me up with some tracks, Big Wayne, his brother. You know, I got some tracks from them homies. My nigga Jay Gus, what up, boy, I love you. He always keep it 1,000. You know what I'm saying? For me, it took me this long to form a real loyal team in that doing what they say they can do. You know what I mean? If a nigga can manage, a nigga manage. You know what I mean? If a nigga can rap, nigga rap with your camp. You know what I'm saying? If a nigga, you know, make the tracks or record, that's what they do. So, right, that's the most important thing to me. And I got all that working right now, and I know it's finna be something special. Shout out to my homie Trill. Been a long road, you know what I'm saying? He just touched down. One of the realest niggas in the fam. Been down since day one. Did a long stretch, you know what I'm saying? Welcome home, my nigga. It's all good. I mean, you know, like I say, man, we just really preaching this boss lifestyle, man. That's how we want to live. That's how we always live. So, you know, ain't no sense of stopping now. We ain't slowing up. We showing signs of just getting better and better, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of people taking on this Coastline brand, man, because, you know, they enjoying the lifestyle.